Hi, in the previous video you could see me restoring these two hatchets or axes from really bad state to the current state by cleaning up the heads, cleaning up the handles, oiling the handles, adding paracord and this bicycle inner tube for protection, or ranger bands as some people call it, and making the leather sheath for this one. I've been using this one many times already on my hiking trips. It's perfect for small wood, for chopping and splitting small pieces, but not for chopping bigger pieces of wood. So my plan is to make two more, one 60 centimeter and one 50 centimeter. And for this I need, of course, two axe heads. I have, ever since I started with those, I collected a few. I have 100 plus now, but I want to show you the whole process from the beginning till the end. So I am bidding on the local eBay site for these two axe heads. It's about 20 of them, a few axe heads and a few hammer heads. The auction will end in 20 seconds. I'm gonna make my final offer now. Currently it's around $14. And I'm gonna offer max $30, but then in check rounds. And doing that right now. Currently I'm the highest bidder and I won! Ha! You're a witness. That's me. And the winning prize is, I paid 305 crowns, which is 305, $16 for about 8 axe heads and 12 axe heads and about 8 hammer heads. Perfect. Once they arrive, I will continue and keep you updated on the progress on these two new axes. The package has arrived. Let's open it. So, I will use these two for my axes. And when I was talking to my friend Mirek about it, he asked if I can do also one for him. So I selected the third one. But this was already one that I had, because simply in the bunch I bought there was no other good ones for this project. So a previous one that I bought and didn't clean yet will be used for Mirek. This one is my favorite, but it's, I don't know if you can see it, but it's really flat. This one will need a lot of work. This one will need some reprofiling because this is a bit bad. I'll take this part off here, round this up, you'll see. For now, I'm gonna put them in a bath of vinegar and get them cleaned a bit. There you go. Let's check back tonight or tomorrow. Next morning, I'm gonna clean them up a bit. See, the rust is coming off quite nice. and use a brush, wire brush, to clean it up now. Hope you can see the difference. So I'll continue now with the rest and then I'll show you the results. Here they are cleaned. This one I will use for my 60 centimeter X, this one for the 50 centimeter, and this one for my friends who also wants a 50 centimeter. This one looks quite good. This one has 800 marked on it. And I need to reshape the head a bit. And this is completely bad. By the way, this one has also some nice markings. You see these a lot on check axis. I don't know what it means yet, but we'll find out one day. This one looks also quite okay. It appears not to have any markings, but I'm not sure about this. I don't know what it's supposed to be, but it doesn't look like a natural scratch. Further, no markings are visible. Here is the first head. After cleaning up, you can really see the nice hardened part. And now, this head weighs 773.72 grams. And I want to get the weight down to around 600, max 600. So I decided to cut this part out, cut this out, reprofile this a bit, and cut this off. So this would be the X part. I cut off the top already, also this corner, and now this part, I figured I would cut small slices there and then somehow grind it off. Let's see how that goes. I can see it better. This corner is off, this is straight. This is also a little bit profiled more. And now I have to take this out. Done, and now to smoothen it a bit, because now it's all these edges here. Now with the general shape done, I rounded this a bit off here, also here. Made a flat back because it was also damaged. I took off the mushroom shape. Now it's time to hit this with a file. as you can see, this is the part where I cut it, so it's quite thick. And here it's as dull as a butter knife. So, I'm gonna use this file for it and make her sharp. Here we are, finished with filing. Took quite a while, but now the edge is perfectly in the middle. It's not really good visible on the camera, but believe me. So now I continue with sharpening this one. Here's the head, all filed up. Now, the stone, gonna sharpen it. Let's see how sharp it is. Here I got my latest phone bill. Pretty sharp. Let's see if we can also shave. I'm not sure if you can see it, but it also shaves. Good! So, this one is ready now. I will make a nice patina on it later, together with the other two heads. At least now I know that my plan is successful. And now I will start with the other two. Took some effort, but finally it fits. There we go. Cut out the excess. Go. for a side wedge. Here the axe is hung, two wedges on top, like one wooden wedge and two of the metal rounded wedges. And this is it. I'll continue now with the other two axes, same thing. Morning. There are already two coats of olive oil there. This one. You can see the difference with the original piece of wood. And as you can see, I got a little bit carried away, as usual. Here's the one from my friend. Here's the 45 centimeter, here's the 50 centimeter. So I added a 60 centimeter. Only flattened the top, nothing here. And I added a, it was originally 35 centimeters, but I cut off this part. So now it's 28 centimeters. And this one will be for inside at the fireplace for splitting smaller pieces of wood to start the fire. So I will coat some more on a daily basis, and after 1 week should be finished. Here are the finished axes. The 60 centimeter one. I didn't change too much on the profile of this one. All of them have patina with spicy horseradish. So the 60 one and the 50 centimeter one. This head I changed a lot, as you could have seen. And what turned out to be just two axes turned out to be actually a little bit more. One for my friend and colleague, another one for me, but 5 centimeters shorter, and a 35 centimeter axe. So now I did actually in total 5. This one I will definitely not use or take with me. This will be for here at the fireplace, just in case you want to make some smaller kindling to start a fire. This one, and this one I will definitely switch and take with me on some trips and see how it goes. In my next hiking videos you should see the axe in action. Hope you liked it. I did. I learned a lot. And bye bye.